How could a Discord server handle over 2 million active users talking at the same time? That's over 40 football stadiums worth of people, and what server even has all of these people? Midjourney is an AI image generation platform where you enter a prompt and you get a realistic image back. Okay, we know what Midjourney is. But what made Midjourney so different is that they didn't have a user interface or an app. Instead, you would join their Discord server and start using it as a Discord bot, something you don't see often with disruptive technologies. And during the AI boom, Midjourney had existing Discord users and non-Discord users swarming to the server to try and create their AI images. And obviously this was great for Discord because they had more users coming to their platform and using their developer tooling. But Discord had a huge problem. The Discord engineers saw that things were getting slower and slower the larger a server gets. Making messages send slowly or fail altogether would cause huge disruptions to one of the biggest opportunities they had yet. And it was hard to move away from an existing system. The way chat applications typically work is you have all your users connected to a centralized state. Whenever a chat message pops up, you need to send the state to all users and keep them updated. Now, for 5, 10, 15, 20, 50 users, this was all fine. It's computers that we're talking about here, folks. How Discord handled their servers was they used something called Elixir, which is a programming language that runs on top of the Erlang virtual machine, known for being good with fault-tolerant and distributed applications. Each Discord server has one Elixir process sitting in between the clients and the Discord API. Elixir will fan out updates to every single client as they happen. And all of this seems solid, but this is where things started to get a little dicey. You see, no matter what, depending on the server size, it was going to grow quadratically. 1,000 people sending a message is 1 million notifications. 10,000 would be 100 million, etc. So how do we deal with a server that has over 10 million users? Well, let's start poking around. With this system, they were sending out every action from the server to the online users. But think about this. What does your Discord look like? Go ahead, pause the video, go have a look and come back. Make sure you subscribe though. Your main servers are at the very top with a bunch of servers that you still haven't gotten rid of. Lots and lots of them. So the Discord engineers figured, why even send you this information if you're not active in the chat talking? So they marked these users as passive users. And these users are online Discord users who are just chilling elsewhere, not in the server. They would instead send all of the required information for when they click into the server. And this turned out to be massive. It turns out that over 90% of users were passive users. And that meant that their whole system was 90% less expensive. Huge win to me. Despite this though, that means that over 100,000 are still going full speed while the rest are going slow. We still have a huge amount of processes going ham. Now, let's look at the architecture again, okay? Here, bring it down, Will. Yep, no, a bit faster, please. We can see that there's a single point of entry when it comes to handling all of these connections. We have one Elixir process for however many people in this server. And the Discord engineers noticed this and decided to work on something called relays. What if we create more, maybe smaller, Elixir instances in between the sessions and the main server Elixir process? That way, the relays could manage a smaller pool of sessions while keeping in sync with the main Elixir instance. However, we would need to decide what would the main process be responsible for and what could we offload to a relay. So the fanout method was refactored into a library that would run on both the main Elixir instance as well as the relays, with the relays doing a permission check to see if a notification could be sent to a certain user. And sometimes the logic couldn't be shared between the Elixir instance with the relays. So the relays would pass through the voice state management basically unchanged to the main Elixir process. The Discord engineers would also send out a giant list of all available users to the relays. This just kept things simple, but remember, Midjourney was at millions of users, so they created logic that would calculate the required members in each relay, shrinking the amount of space and RAM needed. And this system was working great. In fact, for each relay, there was about 15,000 connected sessions, or users in this case. That means for Midjourney, there were probably up to 66 or so relays. Insane. And this made things so much smoother. But there were still a couple of things that were causing chaos. When someone runs an everyone message, Discord has to take the list of all users and go one by one to see if they're allowed to receive that message. If this takes 1 second, well, this could take forever. Elixir doesn't share memory in the best way, but there's a solution for it, and it's called Erlang Term Storage, which is an in-memory database that supports multiple Elixir instances to safely access the storage. So a hybrid approach was created. The list of all members would go into ETS, and the most recent changes would go into the process heap. And since most members aren't updated all the time, you can store them in the much slower ETS system. And keeping the updates of the most recent users in the heap was a huge performance increase. Once all users was in the storage, you can have a worker process that will handle that at a later time. We've seen with countless other big tech companies like Uber and Instagram handle these large-scale problems by just distributing or offloading this big process onto smaller devices. Half a millisecond seems like, you know, nothing to us, right? If you have a huge list of things and it just takes a millisecond each, whatever. But what happens when that is a million or 10 million or even a billion? That was dramatic, sorry. After that, Discord found massive performance improvements in their Elixir stack, with the presence updates being one of the biggest performance boosters out of all of them. You can see in the graph here. Thanks for watching today's video. If you found this really helpful and you're interested in learning a little bit more, you can actually check out the blog articles that are written by the Discord engineers below, because they are incredible and they go way more into detail. I have the names right here, Yuri Pasetsky and Matt Nowak. They both wrote some excellent articles that this whole entire video was based off of. You definitely got to check it out if you're interested in this type of stuff, because it goes into more details and it's just awesome that they were so vulnerable about how to fix a complicated issue like this. Let me know what you want to see next. Peace out, coders.